Congressman, I think the point of Congressman Irise was that he was waiting. And by the time he left the Liberal Party, it had seemed that Vice President Lenny Robredo was not interested to run. I think many people were surprised as well that she threw her hat in the ring, because media was asking her and she repeatedly kept saying, if kung ako lang magpapatalo, hindi ako tatakbo. Kaya niya pinag-iisipan. And she said that she was meeting with these candidates. Mm. The point here is the accusation of intellectual dishonesty, which they claim may cost the alternative candidates a full loss because so many of them are running. Mm. I think that's the issue here.
Okay. Well, intellectual dishonesty. Malalim yun. Okay.
Yeah. In other words, in the whole time that the vice president meeting with these candidates, deep inside, did she really want to run herself? That's the accusation mm-hmm. of the Action Democratico Party.
Okay. Una, sinabi ni ma'am, I think in earlier interviews, no, 3 months ago, she said categorically na she was open to running. So when you go to a negotiating table, you lay your cards out in the open. So running as a presidential candidate is one of them. Being vice also or not running at all, andyan lahat yan eh. So when she tried to her best, to exhausted all efforts to talk to Senator Manny, Mayor Isko, Senator Ping, no? Hindi naman niya sasabihin, no? Sige, let's talk. Let's hope that there's one presidential candidate among the opposition at ako yon. Pero alam nila Mayor Isko, nila Senator Manny ni Ping na she was interested in running, no? But her main objective or priority was to try to unite the opposition, no? And then when all talks broke down, she had a reflection, no? And she felt that she was the best person to represent the ideals and the conviction of the true opposition. No?
Okay.
Ako kasi, well, iba siguro yung pagtingin ni Egay, Erise, pero ako, in my conversations with Lenny, I know that the decision is very, very difficult, but she was always insinuating that running for president is also an option.
Okay. Now, Congressman, the vice president is running as an independent and is using the color pink, and yet she's the chairman of the Liberal Party, the head of the Liberal Party. Her vice presidential candidate is Kiko Pangilinan, who is with the Liberal Party. So frankly speaking, it's confusing to also some people. Why run as an independent when you are chair of the Liberal Party and you have the Liberal Party backing her up with no less than former Senator Bam Aquino as her campaign strategist?
Well, first of all, I like pink. I still like yellow, but I like
you're
pink.
You're wearing pink. Wearing pink right now.
It's Pink Wednesday.
Is pink the new color of the Liberal Party?
It's Pink Wednesday. The use of colors during elections is popular. But what's more important is what you represent. And if Lenny Robredo represents hope for a lot of people, she represents genuine change. And if she feels that pink is the color representation, then we're fine with it, no? The decision to run as an independent was more tactical than anything else, because she's still the chairperson of the Liberal Party. Kung titignan natin, lahat ng mga kandidato ngayon, maliban lang kay Vice President Lenny Robredo, lumipat lang sila ng partido rin eh.
But then, Congressman, that's why there are memes on social media calling the vice president hypocritical. I'm sure you've seen these memes that by filing as an independent, running as using a different color, but your very base and the party you're with is still the Liberal Party, it doesn't change the fact that you are who you are. That's the essence of these memes. So yeah. How would you describe VP Lenny? Is she an independent or is she still with the Liberal Party?
She's a liberal. She's still our chairperson. She hasn't left the party. but she filed as an independent. And as I've said, it's more tactical than anything else, because right now yung mga politicians who belong to other parties but who like her convictions, who want to support her, are talking to us. Makes them more comfortable now that she's an independent. At maraming mga grupo, no, her base, unaligned persons or non-partisan organizations who feel they really like to support VP Leni, but they don't want to be identified as liberal, or they don't want to join the
party. And you and the Liberal Party admits this, that there are stakeholders, there are members that do not like the Liberal Party or yung tinatawag nilang dilawan. Alam nyo yun on the ground.
5 years we've been subjected to that, Karen. We've been trolled, we've been bashed. Our members who join us, they say, you know, sometimes it's so difficult to recruit members because of the Dilawan tag, no? So, but yun nga, sabi nga namin, what's more important is she still believes in our core values of democracy and human rights, no? And then if you look at the other candidates, si Isko nga, from UNA to PMP to NUP to Aksyon, si Senator Manny from PDP to Promdi, si Bongbong Marcos from KBL Nationalista Party to Partido Federalista. Si Leni lang says, okay, I'll still with the Liberal Party, but I'm filing as independent to be more inclusive. No? Sinabi niya sa kanyang speech, I will no longer be the president of the Liberal Party, magiging ina na ako ng bayan. So that's the message that she's trying to convey. And I would admit, Karen, initially, we are members and helped explain that. Kasi meron din nangangamba, no? There was elation, of course, and then when she filed as independent, there were those from the base. The others, they felt it was a good move. Karamihan nagsabi, that's a good move. But our base, our members, our politicians, we had to talk to them. And we reminded them that, di ba, no, a month ago, we passed that resolution that we put full trust and confidence, you know, in Leni. And when they heard her explain the following day, you know, in the press conference with Senator Kiko Pangilinan, naintindak naman nila.
But was getting Senator Kiko Pangilinan a good move? In the beginning, when the vice president filed as an independent, you did feel some kind of momentum and relief coming from some sectors that she was distancing herself from the Liberal Party. But then in choosing Senator Kiko Pangilinan, it just reinforces she is still with the Liberal Party. Yeah. Would you consider that a good move? Yes. Although Kiko did say he's willing to slide down. But was that part of the negotiations? Was getting a vice presidential candidate from the Liberal Party a must?
There was always the option. It has to be somebody who was attuned to what Mom Leni represents as a liberal. No? We talked with liberals. No? Bam Aquino, Senator Frank Drilon, they declined.
But why even get a vice presidential candidate? You have a former Senator Bongbong Marcos, who is ranking very high in the polls. He didn't even choose a vice presidential candidate.
Well, kasi importante yung president, di ba? We always say that the president is incapacitated or something bad happens to the president, then the vice president takes over. So importante na yung pinili mong vice presidential candidate is somebody you really trust to take over the reins of government. No?
But then in running, in choosing Senator Kiko Pangilinan, wherein Senator Kiko Pangilinan and Senate President Tito Soto may roughly have the same base, wouldn't you be giving the administration, Senator Bongo, frankly, a bigger chance to win? Because you've seen the numbers with Senate President Tito Soto. He was 10 points ahead of President Duterte. So you do have some sectors saying, why didn't they just give it to Tito Soto? And number two, Soto, who are family members. So you do have questions in several sectors saying, doesn't the Liberal Party also think? I've heard that. You know what I mean? In other words, it's not looking at the whole picture. In this desire to run and run and run, you're giving the other side, the administration, who's quite solid, mind you, a bigger chance at victory. It seems that with the alternatives and the opposition, the impression is everybody's so selfish, they all want to run for president. Do you understand?
Sa akin kasi, the tandem has its strengths, which we can capitalize on. I mean,
but nobody votes for a tandem in the Philippines. You know that.
Well, it's about time that we think that we should consider the harmony between the top two leaders of our country. Diba? There will always be criticisms. There will always be criticisms on the tandems. They will say, oh, strange bedfellows. No, hindi pa tapos naman kasi. There's still November 15. Who knows? We might have different tandems, diba? People will always say, strange bedfellows. Mag-aaway lang yan. But at least with Vice President Robredo and Senator Pangilinan, their party mates, no, they feel very comfortable with each other. They stand for the same things. No? It solidifies your base. No? And Senator Pangilinan has his strengths, has his track record. No? So definitely, he will also get his own supporters, no, into supporting the entire slate. No? He comes from a different region, Central Luzon. No? Si Ma'am naman sa Bicol. His experience is also valuable. He has helped run national campaigns, no, since 2010. So we feel it's a good combination. No? You can think of a lot of other combinations. Lenny Tito Soto, yeah, malakas, but strange bedfellows. You have to remember that Tito Soto.
Why would that be? He's known as a consensus builder. I mean, in the Senate, that's why he's Senate President. Is Senate President Tito Soto is known to work with all senators?
Well, I'm just one. One is with Ping. It's with Ping, you know. It was very clear during the negotiations with all the camps that the tandem is Ping Lacson and Tito Soto. Mas maraming magtatanong kung sakaling bigyan na lang hiniwanan ni Tito Soto si Ping Lacson. He's also with the
NPC. I'm trying to say it's not about leaving the tandem you're with. I'm saying, did the vice president need someone from the Liberal Party if she was trying to distance herself from the Liberal Party by filing independent and wearing pink? That's my question. Doesn't this, in other words,
okay, Karen, yeah, I understand. But sabi ko nga, diba, na
doesn't this defeat the purpose of distancing yourself?
For those who agreed, and there are a lot of them, with the decision of Ma'am to file independent, that was good, diba? Second, we had to talk to our base. Base who had questions. Has Ma'am left the Liberal Party? By choosing Senator Francis Pangilinan, who is also the party president, and that also solidifies and cultures all perceptions or doubts from our party base. So I think it's a good decision. You reel in those people who want to help her without being identified, or don't want to be identified as liberals. And at the same time, by taking in Senator Pangilinan, you consolidate the base.
All right. Now, my next question. Congressman Edgar Arise said that if a Marcos wins or the Duterte administration proliferates, Vice President Lenny Robredo is to blame. Because he claims this. He claims if the vice president withdraws, 80% or 90% of her votes, studies show, will go to Isko. But he says if Mayor Isko withdraws, his votes don't necessarily go to the vice president's. Your reaction to that?
Well, ako, I really feel that our base is different from Isko.
Okay.
Our base is, that's also shown in our polling, in our own surveys. Because one is that the base is the opposition since 2016. Mm. That's your base, diba? Ito yung mga nanalig, patuloy na nagra-rally, the Sambayan group also. That's also the organization that attempted to enter the position. That's also part of your base. No? That's not Isko's base. We can always say also that kung mag-withdraw rin si Isko or si Manny, pupunta rin sila kay Ma. But what we're more comfortable in stressing that our base will continue to flourish whether Isko stays or withdraws from the race.
Are there still efforts on your end? I mean, the Liberal Party's end. Lito Banayo, who is the campaign of Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, said unification between Isko and VP Lenny doesn't sound too good at this point. Doesn't look possible. But what about Manny Pacquiao? Strategically speaking, are you still open? Or have those talks bogged down?
In principle, we are. The lines are still open. But as far as I know, there's no nego talks at this point. We're more concerned in doing negotiations at the local level.
What's interesting is many people may have forgotten in 2016, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte actually endorsed Vice President Lenny Robredo for the vice presidency. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Yes. So many people have forgotten that today. But yeah. Are you hoping, what will an endorsement from Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte mean for Vice President Lenny?
Well, if she endorses VP Lenny, then emphasizes our belief that she, whether you're DDS or Dilawan or whatever color you identify with or branding you identify with, that she's the best candidate to take over from President Digong Duterte. Because in 2016, there were may duro eh, Duterte Robredo, strong movement also. No? So that's why, unfortunately, because of the branding, because of the trolling, no? She's been identified as this, pero she's really very inclusive. You know, she took it from Secretary Jesse Robredo's gamemanship. Si Jesse kasi magaling sa ganyan eh. Ano man yung partido mo, magaling siyang tumuloy. That's where VP Lenny learned. So I think I would like to think that there's still mutual respect between Sara and Lenny. But of course, si Ma'am clear naman siya. Ito yung guhit ko. Sasabihin ko yung mali, no? At itatama ko yung dapat itama.
Okay. Congressman, I know you're running for the Senate, but in the lower house, just with the numbers, how many Liberal Party members are left in the lower house as we speak? Are you 35, 36?
No, we were down to 15. Egay left, it's now 14. But Congresswoman Beng Abueg of Palawan transferred to us recently. So it's still the same number. There are a lot of politicians actually who've been coming to us, who filed as liberals. No? Gardens, si Ann Gordon has filed.
So you have 14 left. 14 left in the lower house.
Yes, yes.
And this is the smallest, I'm presuming you've been, of course, coming from former President Aquino.
After President Aquino. Before that, we were even smaller. Sabi nga ni Engel, always a common joke, para kaming Volkswagen. Ngayon ang minibus. Minibus naman kami ngayon.
Okay. Congressman, some questions from our reporters who are watching right now. Just very quickly, I asked you already about Manny Pacquiao, the status of the unity talks. So I'll ask it again. In principle, you said yes. Talks are open with VP Lenny and Manny, but is VP Lenny currently speaking with Senator Manny Pacquiao on the possibility of uniting?
There are no nega talks with all of the camps, as far as I know. The talks are now focused in trying to fill up the Senate slate. That's one. And conversations with politicians at the local level. Those are the ongoing talks that I know of right now.
Yeah. And when is VP Lenny's camp going to kick off her campaign or start visiting other areas. What's her starting point?
Nagsisimula na eh. Actually, nagsisimula na eh. She's been going around the country naman eh, even before she declared that she was a candidate. So I think every week, that's their mantra, no? The countryside, they go to the places where they have projects, no? Whether it's Angat Buhay or Vaccine Express, no? So I think it will still continue, perhaps at a more frenzied pace because now that she's a candidate, I hope to join them during their sorties. So it's still business as usual, more frenetic lang at this point.
Mm. Okay. Congressman also called on both candidates, Isko and VP Lenny, to be fair, and he said this: whoever ranks higher in the next survey, because there still is till November 15, he's calling on both of them for the willingness to step down or withdraw, slide down, to give a chance for a stronger alternative opposition that can beat the administration. Mm-hmm. What do you think of that? I mean, that's what actually Senator Ping Lacson suggested in the beginning. And then he says VP Lenny outrightly declined. And then now he says she was open to it, but he said too many people are involved. What do you think of that suggestion? It sounds practical. It sounds strategic.
Mm-hmm. First of all, we feel our numbers will improve dramatically. So it's a risk if you make that call, no? for them. No? Second, kasi lagi nilang sinasabi, to unite the opposition. The question, fundamental question for me is, who is the true opposition? Mm-hmm. As I said, we have our own base. No? The true opposition is our base. Will supporters, will sambayan, will all the other blocks, makabayan, those who have been against this administration from the very beginning, be comfortable in adopting Senator Ping? One of the issues is anti-terror.
But then you just said that she was inclusive. I mean, are you trying to tell me, are you listening to yourself? I mean, you said she was inclusive.
Yeah.
You disagree on certain issues, then you'll never include anyone else, because not everybody can agree on everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, but she did say her main issue were two things: hindi na magpatuloy ang administrasyong ito, walang makabalik na Marcos sa gobyerno. I mean, in her speeches. So yeah. It seems everything else is very secondary to her at this point, because she said the situations, the times are different.
We feel that she has the strength, she has the momentum now to be that person who will make sure that the Duterteismo will not return and that we will not have a reincarnation of the Marshall regime. We're confident in that.
Here's a writer also asking a question right now, saying, Karen, why run independent and not as a rainbow? Why run in an independent? She should have stayed with LP and just had a rainbow coalition.
Well, I already explained that there were really, because Simam, when she decides, she hears from everybody. And I think most everyone said or advised that we will gain more adherents, people who will really go out and say that we will support as an independent. But again, we have to stress that she hasn't left the party. The base, the members, the politicians, the chapters are still fully supportive of her. So it's the best of both worlds. You appeal to the non-aligned the other political parties, and at the same time, you keep your base by staying with the party as the chairperson, by having Senator Francis Pangilinan as your running mate.
All right. On my last note is, you are running for the Senate, right? And the big question for you is, why run for the Senate? I mean, you've seen the surveys. It's a bit tight. What's the intent?
No, it's going to be very difficult. But I'd like to do something historic, to be the first Katutubo, the first indigenous person in Senate. If you look at the Senate, it's supposed to be a representation of the national constituency. Never has there been someone from from Catutubo, also someone from the rural areas, because I'm from Ifugao, from the mountains. I have had experience of governor and mayor, and record in the House of Representatives is something that I can present to the people. Pero sa akin, mas importante is be the voice of the people who don't normally have representation in the Senate. Diba? If you look at the Senate, that's the power black elite, political dynasties, big business, multimillionaires. Somebody naman from the indigenous peoples. And bringing in my advocacies, environment, freedom of information, all of those things. So that's the reason why I'm running for the Senate.
Well, good luck to you, sir, Congressman Teddy Bagila. Thank you for joining me today on Kyadstar, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Karen.